What happened was the guy jumped over that gate, threw up his hands, and the cops started pulling out their blackjacks, beating on them. Oh, you know, I think is happened, he grabbed one of their guns and started shooting at them, and they started shooting back. And it was all over with after that. He jumped out, got into one of their cars. They still were shooting at him while he was in the cop car. And he went about his way.
How long were they beating him? And what exactly were they using blackjack?
It was very quick. I would say about a minute or two. And then, you know, I guess his reaction was to grab one of their weapons. And he grabbed one of their weapons.
After
they was beating him.
They started shooting at him. Then he grabbed their gun. What happened is that car was...
You saw him grab the gun.
It was children out here. They were playing. And next thing we know, this car, the green car, hit that car. When that car was hit, they started, we saw a cop start coming everywhere. The guy came over that gate over
there.
Just
one guy.
One guy. They started chasing him. He put his hands up to give up. Once he gave up, the cop started beating him. Then we heard gunshots ringing out, so we had all the children go in the house. Once they started beating him, they started shooting at him. He grabbed one of their guns and sped off from one of the cop cars. But, I mean, it was like, right now it was like 45 markers for gunshots. There's no business for them to be shooting. There was so many children out here.
What's your name?
D-A-N.
D-A-N?
D-double-A.
Okay, double-A.
I-N.
A-H.
A-H. Cool.
P-O-L-L. P-O-L-L-A.
P-O-L-L-A.
O-L-L.
No,
got it. And your name is?
K-E-V-A. Right.
Dandridge.
A-N.
R-I-N.
D-G-A.
My grandmother was out here fixing the children. Like, they all sit right there. And then all of a sudden, we seen the car get hit.
Were you out here too?
We all were out here.
Yeah.
We were sitting at the table with the kids.
Yeah.
How many kids?
The children in the house.
They know
about
seven, eight of them.
Really?
Yeah.
We made them go in the house with them.
Thank you, ladies.
You're welcome.
Appreciate
it. You're
welcome. Yeah, I got a 26.
Fearing what we might do, and you can give me all mine in cash, that will suffice, dude. In the streets deep, we roll through the city. Looks like it's time to eat, so yo, who's with me? Strictly, we keep it in the best perspective, cause nowadays it's more than simply live and let live. A sedative, that's what these head cases need. Them rats will get trapped soon as they taste the cheese. Black Lucchese fan, just pay us and scram. Watch us drop a new supply to up the daily demand. Phony critics wanna retract shit once I spit again, and since we didn't finish the job, you get hit again.
One, two, devastating. On the mic. One, two, shot to the chin. Knock you out. One, two, devastating. On the mic. One, two. The make up.
You didn't listen when I told you before. When it comes to dope tracks, we be holding the roar. Do something stupid, and you'll be left holding your jaw. Put you punks on blast for not knowing the law. Don't deny yourself, learn to apply yourself, or end up by yourself. I multiply the wealth. I got the titles, deeds, licenses, and policies. Complete ownership. Dongle Rizzy, they call me. Primo said that we should just lock it all down. See the bigger picture, so we can profit all around. Now everybody's riding the dick once I spit again. And since we didn't finish the job, you getting hit again.
One, two, devastating. On the mic. One, two. Shot to the chin. Knock you out. One, two, devastating. On the mic. One, two. The makeup. Owner.
I be the owner of this style, owner of this talk, owner of this art. The gully way that I walk. Many say that I rock. Others hate, but they jock. Now we racing the clock. Popo casing the spot. Call me greedy, cause I feel like taking a lot. Vindication, cause they be fabricating a lot. From Cali to Canarsie, penthouse to the lobby. Roxbury to NC, Century Club to Envy. About to take over the action. You know it's about to happen, cause our shit be hitting, and yours is plain old fashioned. I had no choice but to spit again. Gangstar, motherfucker, and you just got hit again.
One, two. Devastating. On the mic. One, two. Shot to the chin. Knock you out. devastate.
On the mic. One, two. The makeup.
This was the scene as more than 40 police cars chased after the suspect up North Broad Street. They get word that other officers have him cornered at 26th and Oxford, and the chase cars peel off in that direction. Initially, just one officer has his gun on the suspect, and then the car is surrounded as other cops arrive. The door opens briefly here, but he doesn't come out. Here you see the door opening. Finally, one officer reaches in and drags the suspect out. The officer in the black here drags.
I heard the shots coming. I heard it, but I didn't physically see anything.
How many?
Probably seems like a million shots. A million.
There may not have really been a million, but the 45 plus shots fired at the corner of 17th and Francis Streets seem to go on forever for those who heard the commotion. You get the idea by the number of yellow cards placed on the street, marking each bullet casing. Police had thought they finally had cornered a carjacking suspect here. They say he was driving the very car that was stolen from a shopper back on July 1st, very erratically through North Philadelphia around noontime. After a police chase, the suspect rammed into another car, injuring two people, jumped out, and hopped a gate. By that time, a number of people were watching this unfold.
The guy jumped over that gate, threw up his hands, and the cops started pulling out their blackjacks, beating on them. Oh, you know, I think is happening, he grabbed one of their guns and started shooting at them, and they started shooting back.
Then the suspect somehow managed to get away by stealing a police cruiser right from the scene. Yet another chase began, leading what witnesses say was an endless caravan of police cars to 26th and Oxford. Chopper 6 shows the moment the suspect was cornered there and apprehended by police. He had been shot 5 times throughout the incident and was transported to Temple Hospital. The stolen police cruiser had numerous bullet holes and a blown out back window.
Look at him beating on him before he can get out the car.
To hear family members speak, you'd think Thomas Jones would be the last person to steal a car and flee police, let alone shoot at an officer. The last time his mother saw him, he was fixing a car like he did for many of his neighbors. The next time, he was in surgery with bullet wounds in his abdomen and under arrest.
Terrible, terrible. His face is all messed up. You know, he's handcuffed down.
Thomas Jones, seen here in an old family photo, was engaged to be married next year. His fiance says in the 4 years she's known him, he had one arrest for assault when he took a child's bicycle to chase down robbery suspects. She says she's deeply concerned at the large number of police used to bring Thomas under arrest.
I can't even look at that tape, to be honest with you. What I see is a couple of fools. They would have just did their job instead of trying to play Mr. Hero. If they would have just locked him up, I don't think this would have been going this far, would it?
The family acknowledges Jones has a less than perfect past and says while they've been unable to talk to him, the man they know probably fled from police out of fear. Having looked at the video of his arrest themselves now and the blood spattering on his shorts, they question whether anyone could have seen him as a threat once the stolen police cruiser he was in came to rest.
The cops had no business shooting nobody more than one time without they not resisting arrest. I mean, if they said he got shot 5 times, how can he possibly still be resisting arrest?
All right.
Just look at me
in
the camera. Your name is? Aisha Williams. Spell that for me. A-Y-E-S-H-A. And you saw what happened?
Yes, we did. We both did. Me and him, we was all standing out here at the time.
What happened?
Well, when they had the accident right there at the corner and Brown, it was that 17th and Brown. Me and my aunt ran to the door because we didn't know what was going on because we knew kids was out here. And my son usually sits outside and I thought he went in the street. So we ran outside. We seen the guy run down Brown by the pile up Perkiomen Street. We didn't see what happened after he got around the corner, because by the time we got to the corner, all the cops was running that way. So we went to go check on my mother, because she lives on the end of Perkiomen Street. So by the time we came back up the street to find out what was going up Francis Street, he was coming over the gate.
Okay.
He was coming over the gate. That's when we seen all the cops running towards the gate, and he was trying to get over the gate. And one cop had his leg, and he had his hands on the gate trying to get over, and they had pepper sprayed them in his eyes. He jumped over the gate. A couple cops was coming up this way as they was pursuing to the accident, the scene. They start right here in front of the car. They had jumped, and start tussling with him to try to get him in the car. One cop opened up the car door to put him in, and the other cop was trying to push him, and he started tussling, trying to get away from him. And that's when they started hitting him to get him in the car. Some way he got away from him. And one cop drew his gun, and the other cop was trying to put him in, and that's when the gun went off. But it wasn't his gun. It was the cop gun that went off. And that's when the other cop, Litwell, whatever one that's hurt, reacted to say that I've been shot. By the time me and my aunt had got, well, my aunt was already at the step. I was at the next step coming up, and he walked past me saying I was shot. So that's when I stopped another cop and said, well, one of your officers got shot. That's when they was putting him in a car, and all of a sudden, when they heard the other gunshot go off, another cop was shooting at him as he was in the car. And that's when all of them start sort of shooting, and he was in the back.
Okay, let's back up.
The back of the car.
Let's back up. He was being shot.
As he was in the car.
After the officers learned that there was an officer that had been
hurt. So they thought he had shot the cop, but he didn't. And they just started shooting anything, and they let off a lot of rounds, and soon he passed the foot of Francis Street, he was going down, and they were still shooting.
So was he in custody when they shot him?
He didn't have no handcuff, but they did have him. They did catch him, but he just got away by tussling and, you know, got out of his
arms. It was all like they all was grabbing him. He was a big man. And he was like pushing a lot of them off. And he happened to get away and got in the car. Like a couple of them has his feet or whatever, so he kicked off and got in the car. Once he got in the car, they just started letting numerous rounds off on him. It just sounded like something straight out of a movie. Because I was like in the window, because I got a lot of kids in the house. I was telling them, get down. Because they just start.
Because kids used to be right here, actually right here every day.
With a swimming pool. My grandma had a swimming pool
playing. And me and my aunt and his grandma be sitting out here every day. But lucky today that we wasn't, but it was kids out here. And because it happened right here in front of this door, in front of his car.
Right here. Something like right out of a movie, like it's like there are like 100 shots or something.
Well,
like,
as they was circling down the block, it was 57 rounds or 53 or something rounds.
It sounds like you all were saying they didn't have to shoot him.
Correct. He didn't have a gun.
And he had to get shot like that, and he didn't have to get beat down. Even though the crime that you done, you still do not deserve nothing like that. And the way they caught him up Susquehanna, the way they beat him, it didn't have to go down like that.
Because they all thought, because an officer got shot, they assumed that he did it. And that's why they took the actions they did, thinking that he shot a cop.
So, you're saying he didn't shoot the officer?
He didn't shoot the officer. Another cop shot, and the other one just got shot by accident. He did not shoot no cop because he did not have no gun.
Say that again. How did the officer get shot?
One of his partners was shooting, he just got shot that way because when the gun went off, he just got hurt. But the guy that was driving the car, he did not have no gun. Because when he was coming over the gate, both of his hands was on the gate.
Pardon me?
He had two hands on the gate trying to get over the gate.
He did not have a weapon.
No, he did not.
Your thoughts on all this?
Yes, we was actually right here. We seen the whole thing.
No, I said your thoughts on it.
I was frightened. All I heard was gunshots. I was just so for the little ones I had in the house, I was trying to get them down. So, because a bullet could have easily went through the window. So I just was trying to get the little ones safe, secure first.
Your name is?
Sean Murphy.
Spell your first name.
S-H-A-W-N.
Murphy,
common
spelling.
Yeah.
About what time of day was it?
A little after 12. Okay.
And what gate were you talking about?
This one right there between the two houses.
Because it started over there. Right.
Okay, so he
ran up that block, and it's like an opening over there.
Another section.
So he came through, like, from the opening, you can get through here. Mm-hmm. So he came through here.
Well, it usually be locked.
Cut him off,
but the guy was back there cutting grass at the time.
So when he climbed over this fence, what happened?
He jumped down by the steps. That's my house. He jumped down off the gate and ran into the street. That's when they caught him right here.
Okay. And then they put him in the car.
That's when they was trying to get him in the car because one cop opened up the car door.
And then he was shot while he was inside the car.
Yes, they was shooting, you know, I guess in some way the gun went off. I don't know if they were shooting at him at the time, but whatever. The gun went off because they did have it drawn. You know what I'm saying? I don't know if somebody bumped into him and made his hand hit the trigger or whatever, but he was shot.
Have the police interviewed you all at all?
No, because I did not want to get into it. Thank you.
I thought somebody was going to move. run through, you got me here, then you come back with the stick.
Thank you very much.
You said they got my
dad. I'm here. All of you, tell us why that incident that happened yesterday can happen in Francisville. Would you sign this, please? Thank you.
Hey, Schoenberg, how you doing? This is Schoenberg.
We're trying to organize a meeting here in Francisville for the residents.
Hey, I'm going to go to the
It's happening. They're all like downstairs here.
Everybody up there on 18 sign.
Okay. Your name is?
Ada Keith.
Spell that for me.
It's A-D-A-K-E-I-T-H.
Tell me what you saw from beginning to end.
Okay, we heard the accident. So me and my niece jumped up, came to the door and looked. Okay, as we were standing on the step, we seen a cop car racing up Brown Street. Okay, so we looked again. By the time I came off the step, top step gun, the step, we seen a guy running this way, and the cop's car come from down Francis Street, and the one coming around Brown Street. So we runs to the corner. Okay, when I noticed that the man was coming around and running on the lot, I noticed my back door is open. So it's my front door. So I runs back. By the time I run back, I see the man coming over the gate. I was right standing right here. As he was coming over the gate, they had pepper sprayed him. He stood right here as he was coming, trying to get something together. They already did it right here in the lot. They continued pepper spraying as he came over the fence. So I'm sitting there watching. Is he going to go in my house? That's what I'm thinking. So he continued to go over. That's when the cops came over the gate. And they tussled with him when he got right here by the car. Mm-hmm. So as they was tussling with the man, the officer threw his gun out. And Linwood was standing next to the officer on the right side of him. The gun discharged. Shot Linwood in the leg. They said the man had a gun. The man did not have no gun. Okay, so they tussled with him. They said I've been shot. So they all stepped back. Six officers stepped back from the car, open fired on the man. So I'm sitting there saying, this is kind of strange. And as that was going on, the rest of them was coming down. As they were shooting at him, they was running down the street shooting. I'm standing right there. They were shooting. So I'm sitting there saying, now if they're shooting at this man and he had no gun, come on now, I'm thinking. I better duck. That's why I did a duck. So I'm sitting there saying, as they proceeded to go down the street, they kept on constantly shooting at him. And then they drove on off. They took him apart and took off behind him.
In the car, were they shooting him?
They was tussling with him when he was in the car, trying to get him in the car. Okay, as they was tussling, the officer had his gun drawn. And the cop shot at him when he kicked him. I think he bit one of them on her hand or something. And, like, pushed him off, and he, like, sit up, and he closed the door, he shot him. Then he shot again. Then the lady cop stood right there, and she just started open fire on the man. I don't know her name, but she got blind hair. I don't know if she's a detective or whatever. She opened fire on a man, then they all opened fire on a man.
And when she started firing on him.
No, listen to what I'm saying.
Okay.
As they were sitting there, the black cop, gun discharge, shot Linwood.
The smoke, the gun smoke. And I saw the cops, one police car, the tire, it got flat.
Yeah.
And he was coming down Ridge Avenue. So, it was terrible.
Thanks, man.
Not much to say, about 150 cops.
They obviously got the guy.
Yeah, they got him. Got him right away. Put him at the corner.
Can you once again set the scene for us, sir, when you got right out here? What'd you see? What'd you hear?
There was about 100 police cars come flying down the street, and they grabbed the guy right away.
Did you see what happened when they grabbed him?
Yeah, they put him in a wagon.
Anything that was about it? How they put him in?
Yeah, that was it. They just put him in a wagon.
Was it kind of rough the way they
handled it? Yeah, I couldn't see from down here.
What do you think about all this excitement in your neighborhood here?
Excuse me?
What do you think about all this excitement in your neighborhood?
It's normal.
Okay. Can we get your name if we could?
Stan Kaplan.
K-A-P-L-A-N? Thanks, Stan. Yeah. Your business?
Luigi Water Ice.
Thank you. All right, thanks, Stan. Appreciate it. Thank you.
Yeah, I was here during the riots. I've seen it all time.
What kind of water is here? Okay. Don't worry. Stan, yes. That's all right. We got escorted out. Even though we had the family's permission. I don't know what's going on. But Stanley, tell us what you think is important for the public to know.
I mean, then as important is that the cops The cops ain't no business shooting nobody more than one time about they not resisting arrest. I mean, if they said he got shot five times, how can he possibly still be resisting arrest and getting hit and beat or laying on the ground? I mean, this is police. I mean, it's never a police brutality. That's all it is.
Tell us about your uncle.
I mean, my uncle, well, he had the hard knock when he grew up. I mean, everybody get into trouble and stuff in the past, but hey, people change. He ain't been in trouble in a couple years, been out of prison. I was even doing good living a straight life. He's not in prison. I mean, I don't know all the facts of what happened to him, but what I know is my uncle, he always been good to me.
Tell us a little bit about him. I mean, do you think he's the kind of guy who would be in a stolen car knowing
it? I mean, but anybody could be in a stolen. You could be in a, you never know. If somebody gives you a car and say, can you take this for me or not? You don't know what's going on. I mean, I don't know. I don't know if he stole it. It really shouldn't matter if he stole it or he stole it. But that well.
My son and I, we have a federal lawsuit against those officers. I'm from down in the neighborhood. Because they always harass people and they don't respect the law. When that man came out with his hands up, they should have put the cuffs on him. Instead, they all started beating him.
Did you see this for yourself?
Yes.
You were at 17th
and other out 17th and Francis, and other eyewitnesses saw it. The man had his hands up. Okay. They start beating him and they was just pulling up in cars, jumping out, beating him at 17th and Francis. What would you do if all these police was beating you? You either fall on the ground and be half dead or you try to escape. He tried to run. If they had just cuffed him, respected the law, things would never have escalated to the point that it did. But that's how the police are in Philadelphia.
How many police cars were at the scene?
It was about at least eight, and they was coming. They was coming in hot.
Eight cars or eight officers?
Eight cars, and they was coming in hot.
Now,
they was coming in fast.
Did you see anything at the scene where they pulled him out and started beating him? Were you there at that scene?
No, I was not at that scene.
And you said you have a federal lawsuit against two of these officers?
I have a federal lawsuit against Lawrence McKinney and Michael Libro, the one that was shot in his hand.
McKinney is MC...
Lawrence McKinney.
Thank you.
They were both together.
I didn't get to show y'all what he got.
Matter of fact...
K-I-N-N-E-Y?
Yeah.
And Livewell?
And Michael... Whatever his name is, Michael Livewell or whatever.
The guy that got shot in the phone.
And we have a...